Now, this works, technically, but there's a problem. What if we have a dozen types of entities that we might need to spawn? Or 50, or even 100? Real-time strategy games, for instance, contain many different entity definitions. Writing out a spawn entity function to represent all of these items would involve a large case statement that wouldn't really scale well for programmer maintenance over time. For instance, if a designer wanted to add a new type of entity, they'd actually need a programmer's help to do it, to go in and add a specific line of code for that entity type. The problem is further visible if you consider code maintenance. Adding references to class definitions throughout your codebase is just asking for problems. To address this issue, we're going to take advantage of an interesting property in JavaScript, namely that we can create a new object given a handle to its definition. To allow this, each overloaded entity definition will update a hash table with a pointer to its class definition. Once we have a hash table entry between the string name of the instance class, we can then use this instance to create a new version of that class. Remember that in grids, map development is done through a program called Tiled, which allows our content creators to place objects in the world and set their type via a string. This means that the data that we'll be receiving from our map definition file is a list of objects with a string property representing their class type. Our code needs to be able to react to this by using the hash table that maps these string values to the class definitions they represent. What this means is this previous definition of spawn entity function needs to be replaced with a nice healthy reference to this factory object and use it as we've defined.